Good morning, everybody. President's schedule, 8 o'clock. He had normal briefings. He has concluded, I presume, making remarks at the dedication.
Hello, everybody. Questions?
Communism Memorial.
Senator Spector.
At 12:30, he'll return to Capitol Hill. There will be a meeting with Republican Senate leadership, followed at 1 o'clock. By a Senate Republican policy
line. We're going to review the subpoenas and we'll respond
accordingly. We've got a couple of notes up front. For this one. That's the first on July 31st, 2001.
Good afternoon. One thing to add to President this morning had a 52-minute secure video teleconference with the members of the presidential council.
We have made
prime minister, the president, and two vice presidents. The president got a briefing on ongoing activities. It seems that right now, parties
is more interesting
in terms of pursuing political, economic, and social platforms. Those arriving over here also expressed his support for their working together at this juncture.
You know, it's clear considering
what is going on recently in Iraq, the attacks in Syria. At the same time, I continue to issue reaffirm his support for moving forward vigorously.
Last week, it was just not true.
As I mentioned,
how can that be true? Now they're still showing that the White House is a political director.
Half of the Palestinians in Syria and Iran will step in and fill that void.
Our hope most I'll tell you what, rather than my trying to go through in great detail, Secretary Rice is going to be having a press conference between about 1:15 and 1:30 that she's going to have for political appointees
and political officers. During the video teleconference, did the President very directly express his impatience about the lack of political movement?
What he does,
you're saying,
once again,
you assume that politics would be involved in
the political.
About what that reassurance, why he felt reassured, and also address whether or not they're taking a vacation and whether, they're taking a vacation now? But Tony, can you give us some sense of why he felt reassured, given that we've heard reassurances before?
It is clear that you've got an environment now where the key leaders are working together.
The authority to
run these issues. Yes, we have heard a lot of these things.
These were all individuals,
but without
their terms as U.S.
president, not a position to go into the details of what they were saying. But there are reasons.
Something that's deeply personally.
We think they're very serious and moving forward on the key items.
We've heard that before, many times.
I understand.
I mean, why is there any reason, more reason now, to believe that they're serious about moving forward than there was the last time you said that?
I understand. But again, I think, let me put it this way, that you see that there are tangible efforts going on, and I'm just not going to go into any greater detail. I'm going to let that is a sovereign government, and I will permit them to make the announcements about how they're going and where they're going.
You think there'll be announcements on something about where they're going?
I think, I'm just going to leave it at that.
Do you agree with General Petraeus' assessment that it could take about a decade to stabilize Iraq to fully stabilize?
Well, General Petraeus was pointing out, this is pretty much standard doctrine when it comes to counterinsurgency. The counterinsurgency is something that does take a great amount of time. He says 10 years. That does not mean that you're going to have people in a forward combat operation posture for 10 years, but it does mean that he says that it's perfectly conceivable, and that intends to be kind of the textbook.